Hello friend, my name is Kamal Ahmed Qureshi. Today we are going to discuss about the safety measures in the microbiology laboratory. This is the first lab, and we will see that what is the objective of this lab. The aims and objective of this lab is to demonstrate safety measures followed in the microbiology laboratory. Now see that what are the different safety measures we have to follow in the microbiology laboratory. First, wash your hand with disinfectants when you arrive at the lab and again before you leave. So hand wash is first most important things you have to follow. Wear laboratory coats in the lab. Students with long hair must put up the hair. This is another most important thing. You must wear apron or laboratory coat. And students with long hair must put up the hair. Next is at the start and end of each laboratory session, students should clean their assigned benchtop area with a disinfectant solution provided. That space should be kept neat, clean, and uncluttered throughout each laboratory period. So the table where you are working must be neat and clean. Okay, you must clean that table before starting the lab and after finishing the lab. Eating or drinking in the laboratory is not permitted, and no mouth pipetting is allowed. So always remember that, don't bring any food, any water into the microbiology laboratory. It is not permitted, and no mouth pipetting is allowed, because if you will do the mouth pipetting, the microorganism can insert or can go inside your mouth. Label everything clearly. So whatever you are doing, or if you have any test tube or something like that, you must label that. Sterilized equipment and materials. So whatever the instrument or material you are using must be sterile. Avoid loose fitting items of clothing. Wear appropriate shoes in the laboratory. This is also very important. Report any breakage of equipment to the instrument. Report any breakage of equipment to the instructor. If you broke any instrument, any glassware, you must inform to your instructor, because otherwise, it may be more dangerous if you will not inform him. He may take care of that. Report any personal accidents such as cuts to the instructor advance. So, if you have any personal accident such as cuts, you should inform to instructor, because if you have a cut or something, he may take care of you. Burn off Bunsen burner when not in use. So always turn off Bunsen burner when not in use. This is very important. Otherwise, because this is the fire, it may be dangerous to other people also and to the lab. Discard all culture and used glassware into the container labeled contaminated. This container will later be sterilized. Plastic or other disposable items should be discarded separately from glassware in containers to be sterilized. Discard all cultures and used glassware into the container labeled contaminated. Means you must label a container as contaminated. So whatever the contaminated material is there, you must discard that in that container. So after that, this container will be sent for further sterilization, or you can say for the autoclaving, so decontamination. Never place contaminated pipette on the bench top. This is also very important. Otherwise, your table or bench can get contamination and other people can get infection. Before beginning your laboratory exercise, disinfect the bench top with disinfectant provided. So this is also very important. Whenever you are working, the table must be cleaned properly with a disinfectant, and once you finish your exercise, clean that with that same disinfectant. Disinfect the bench top again. Always wash your hands with soap and water before leaving the laboratory. Before leaving the laboratory, see all the equipment is in proper location and gas and water turn off. That this is very important, and this is actually your complete responsibility that no gas, no water tap must be on. Purchase a fine point waterproof marker and a small roll of masking tape. Use them to clearly label your cultures. This is very important. If you should spill or drop a culture, or if any type of accident occurs, call the instructor immediately. Place a paper towel over any spill and pour disinfectant over the towel. Let the disinfectant stand for 15 minutes and then clean the spill with fresh paper towels. Remember to discard the paper towels in the proper receptacle and wash your hand carefully. So if any accident happens, if suppose you from your hand culture bottle or a bacterial culture or any liquid fall down, so what you will do, you have to put the paper, tissue paper, and then put some disinfectant and then wait for 15 minutes. After that, clean that with fresh tissue paper and then discard to a proper container. Disinfect work areas before and after use with 70% alcohol or fresh 10% bleach. So 70% alcohol and 10% bleach is most recommended disinfectant for cleaning the area or cleaning the table where you are working. Laboratory equipment and work surfaces should be decontaminated with an appropriate disinfectant on a routine basis, and especially after spills, splashes or other contamination. Replace caps on reagents, solution bottles and bacterial cultures. So after completing your work, always close the Always place culture tubes. Cultures are not to be removed from the laboratory unless the instructor gives permission. Always place culture tubes, broth and slants in upright position in a rack or basket for incubation or disposal. Dispose of all solid waste material in a biohazard bag and autoclave it before discarding in the regular trash. Treat all cultures as potentially pathogenic, because you are dealing in the microbiology lab, so you must consider that all the cultures you are using, they are harmful. So be careful and consider them as a potentially pathogenic. Flood areas with disinfectant. If cultures are spilled, wash hand after contact and notify your instructor at once. Read properly. Read the instructions carefully before beginning an exercise. Also make sure all the materials needed for the exercise at hand before you commence the experiment. Ask the instructor for clarification of any points about which you in doubt. Flame the inoculating loop or needle immediately before and after use. If viscous material is present on the loop or needle, dry it at the side of the flame before placing it directly in the flame. Laboratory notebook must be kept up to date. List questions should be done when requested. Make sure you consult the instructor to dispose of the culture that are not needed any longer. Remove all labels and markings from the tube before disposing of them. Don't discard anything into the sinks. Please inform your instructor if you have any medical condition that could potentially affect your safety in the lab, like diabetes, epilepsy, immunocompression, immunosuppression, etc. This information will help the instructor to deal with any emergency that would arise. The information will be treated confidentially and it will not affect their ability to participate in the lab activities. Be systematic and logical. Keep a faithful record of all the experiments and observations. Update it regularly and submit it for evaluation at the end of each exercise. Work either using a laminar airflow chamber or light the burner at least 5 minutes prior to making any inoculations and work near the burner. These all are the guidelines you must follow, safety precautions you must follow when you are working in the microbiology lab. Thank you very much.